no plants, no life. Our sun just vanished. Is it even possible? But how? Let's speculate about one of the most unlikely scenarios. What happens if the sun disappears? In today's video of Discover Zen. We know that the sun is the only star in our solar system that gives light and heat for all life to survive on Earth. But for the sake of science and our imagination, let's talk about some of the effects if our sun suddenly vanished. After the sun's disappearance, we would not know anything for the first 8 minutes and 19 seconds, as that's the amount of the time light takes to reach Earth from the sun, and our planet would remain in orbit for the same amount of time, as the gravity has the same speed as that of light, that is 299,792,458 meters per second. Since every planet is at a different distance from the sun, all planets will lose its orbits at different times. For example, Mercury goes first, then Venus, and then Earth, and so on. But it's not only the timing which will be different, the speed with which every planet will go off its orbit will also differ. Mercury will shoot out of its orbit with a speed of 47 kilometers per second, or 29.2 miles per second, while Earth will lose its orbit and free roam in space at about 30 kilometers per second, or 18.6 miles per second. Now let's talk about what will happen to the Earth and all life here. Well, after the sun goes down, we will be floating in space with no stopping by. Space is almost a vacuum, so there are no external forces to stop or decrease our velocity until we find our new sun and lock onto its orbit. But that seems very unlikely. Here on Earth, it will be complete chaos. Plants, trees, and all animals on the surface will freeze to death. Other animals or fishes which live on the upper surface of the ocean or any water bodies will freeze to death a little later than those on the surface. For the living organisms which live underwater, close to the seabed, it would be fine as they don't need sunlight to survive, and that part of the ocean would still remain as a liquid form of water. For us, this would be the greatest challenge ever encountered in our lifetime. When it comes to our survival, we need to construct doomsday bunkers close to the seabed, which is quite possible with present-day technology. The seabed will not be the only option, as we can even build bunkers underground, but that would take an enormous effort, but still doable. We can survive if the bunkers are already built before the sun disappears, but if we don't have it prepared, we won't survive too long once the sun vanishes. For power generation, we would have to rely completely on Earth's geothermal energy. Geothermal energy comes from Earth's core as it's heated up to a temperature of 5,000 degrees Celsius, or 9,032 degrees Fahrenheit. And in an event of the sun disappearing tomorrow, Earth's geothermal energy will last as long as 10 billion years. So not much of a problem in that regard. Food can be grown in small food chambers or through hydroponics farming. We have the hydroponics technology to grow plants in artificial light, and it's much more efficient than traditional farming. Apart from our speculations, is it possible for the sun to disappear suddenly? If our sun runs out of its fuel, or to be more precise, if our sun runs out of nuclear fuel to burn in its core, it causes the core to collapse into a supernova, and in the process, it emits a huge amount of energy. But that can't happen to our sun, because it happens only to those stars which are many times larger than our sun. We can say that our sun isn't eligible to become a supernova, as it does not have enough mass to explode. Another possibility is that our star becomes a white dwarf, which is common with the star size of the sun. But before becoming a white dwarf, the sun will expand and burn as a red giant. But in any case, it is not going to be disappearing on its own. So you don't have to worry about sun vanishing anytime soon. But what happens in the scenario where the Earth is locked tidally to the sun's gravitational field? That sounds like a different topic to speculate and investigate on Discover Zen.